What's going on, guys? My name is Owen, and welcome back to another video. Again, I'm really, really sorry I didn't post for the past few weeks. I've been really busy with finals and school, and now I'm finally back in Boston, so I'm at my old setup. That's why all these hangers look like garbage. I usually have like nice wooden hangers, but don't have that anymore. So I'm just gonna be rolling with this for now, but I have a lot of pickups to show you guys. Obviously, since I haven't uploaded in like the past month, I've just accumulated a lot of items I haven't really shown off on my YouTube. But if you do follow me on Instagram, which is at OwenMHyatt, you probably would have seen a few of these items, not all of them, but definitely a few of them. I believe I have 10 pickups in total that I want to show you guys, but since that's a lot of pickups for one video, I think I'm going to spread out into two videos, just like a two-part series type thing. I haven't decided exactly how I want to do it yet, but I'll probably do one part the day you're seeing this, obviously, and then the next part probably 2 days from then. So if you're wondering why you only see 5 pickups in this video, that's because I'm just gonna be doing a second part just so I can like stretch out the content a little bit more, give myself some more time to make more videos for you guys. Since I'm back in Boston, obviously I'm on school vacation, so I can just make a ton of videos. And that's what I wanna do. I finally bought a new lighting setup, bought another lighting setup so I can actually make videos here. I couldn't do that before. And I was also waiting for a few more things to come in, and they just came in today. So let's hop right into the first pickup. So the first pickup I want to show you guys is a pair of shoes, and these have instantly become one of my favorite pairs of shoes in my collection, just because I don't have anything that's too similar. But anyways, these are the Alix boots in this like brown suede high top version. If you guys saw my Grail wishlist video from probably like, I want to say like 6 months ago, then you would have seen me talk about these shoes, and I wanted them so bad. I think I wanted the green version back then, but same thing, same deal. I couldn't find the green version anymore, but I did find the brown version on sale. Since it is like the whole Black Friday, Cyber Monday week type thing, you're gonna find these on sale for a pretty decent price. I believe I got these for around $600, but I know now you can get them for even cheaper, like closer to like $450, $500. So I'll leave some links down in the description below, but these are just a pretty simple Alix hiking boot. They're super similar to all the other ones in that they have the same sole with like the teeth and that same ridge on the inside, the same heel. Basically the entire bottom of the shoe is the same as all the other Alix hiking boots, except where it changes a little bit is the upper. It is a high top brown suede upper. I don't have any brown suede boots. Back in the day, like 2.5 years ago, I did have those super corny Chelsea boots that kind of like everybody had back then, but these are like a good alternative, I think. I think they have that similar style, but they obviously have a lot more my style now. I did go true size on these, like all Alix hiking boots. I usually go with a 43 or 44, and they turned out perfect. I think these fit me really, really nice, and obviously since they're brown, you can kind of pair it up with a lot of stuff. I believe I wore these in the past 2 Instagram outfit pictures I've posted, so if you follow me on Instagram, you would have already seen these in a couple outfits already. The top part is a little flimsy, which is kind of interesting, and then on the inside right here, it has a flap that covers a zipper, and when you want to unzip it, you can just like, you can just kind of like expose it, pull down the zipper like that. It goes all the way down. It's not like the greatest zipper, I'm not gonna lie, but it is still pretty good, and I like the little, zipper or attachment handle thing. And then, you know, it's kind of difficult to get your foot in a little bit, but kind of like with all boots like this, it's pretty difficult. Yeah, it's got some cool paneling. It's kind of hard to see, but it's got a panel that comes down here and then it cuts across right there. And then it's got a panel that goes across the back and then back over like that. But yeah, let me know what you guys think of these shoes down in the comments. I'm really curious to hear your opinion. I am gonna have some links down in the description if you guys want to catch some Black Friday deals. Hopefully they're not sold out. I haven't checked in the past couple days, but they were in stock and they did have the same size at like a really decent price. So definitely go check that out. Now let's move on to some pants. I have a lot of pants pickups that I wanna show you guys. I think I have 5 pairs of pants. And the first pair I wanna show you guys is this pair of cargo pants that I got right here. These are a pair of Acne cargo pants. I don't remember like what they're called, but they're like really baggy, extremely, extremely wide pants. I know they did have these on Essence, but I actually bought these off Grail just because it was a little bit cheaper since they were obviously used. These are honestly really like simple casual pants. They're just kind of like your basic cargo pant in a really nice like green color, which is pretty standard for cargo pants. But I really like the material. It's like a really thick cotton. It keeps me warm in the winter, obviously, since it's freezing outside. There's not like too much design elements to them. I just really wanted like a nice, extremely baggy pair of pants that I can kind of just wear with anything that's like extremely versatile. The only Acne branding is on the inside tag right there, but nowhere else you see Acne branding, which I like, just like with a lot of other Acne stuff. It's got like 2 little strings at the bottom right there. I think I got them for around like 200 or 220, which is a pretty decent price. They might be on sale for Black Friday, so definitely go check it out. I might have a link down in the description. I really like how these fit on me. They have like the perfect amount of stacking at the bottom since they're nice and baggy and they're also really, really long. Acne is kind of like one of the perfect places to get any of your essentials, so definitely go check them out if you haven't before. Okay, so moving on to the next pair of pants I want to show you guys. These are an archive piece if you guys were curious. I have had my eye on these for a really long time. These are the CDG Cuba Denim from I believe like 2005, I want to say. I don't remember the year exactly. I do have a crew neck sweatshirt and a Carhartt like custom painted jacket that I did. I'm sure a lot of you guys know what that is, but this has the same design, like the same motif or whatever. Has the guy that I painted right there, but obviously I didn't paint this one. It's got a woman right there. It's got some words all over it too. It says pan right there, which I think just means bread, but could be wrong. And then the cool thing is on the back side, it actually has nothing. So there are a few different versions of like the Cuba stuff. There is a version where I think it's just red all over. And there is another version that has like a comic print. They have like shoes in that. They have button ups. They have pants. They have a couple other stuff too. This collection is really sick and I do love these pants, but I don't know. Like once I got them in hand, I was kind of like, I wasn't really wowed by them. I don't know. I think the fit is really nice. I don't know, maybe I just can't really pair anything up nicely with this red. It is kind of like an interesting red, and I think a lot of my shoes don't really pair up nicely with these jeans, so I might be letting go of these. Thank you, Alfred, by the way. Alfred gave me a really good price on these. I wish I could keep them. I can't justify keeping a pair of jeans this expensive if I'm not gonna wear them too often. So I'd rather give them to another home. So if you guys are interested in these are like a size, these are a size medium, so probably like a 30 to 32, that's how they fit me. If you guys are interested in these, just hit me with a DM. And we can talk about price and all that stuff, but obviously come prepared knowing what these are worth. Yeah, I don't know, I guess it's just that I don't have any shoes that kind of pair up with this nicely. It is a really good cut of jeans and like I really wish I could keep it, but I can't justify it at this point. I have so many pairs of jeans and I have so many just pairs of pants in general too, so I gotta be kind of selective with my wardrobe now, especially since I'm away from home. I gotta bring back the same amount of stuff that I left with essentially. Let's move on to a top, and the first one I want to show you guys is this ginormous Yeezy Season 3 Shirling yellow jacket. I'm sure you guys have seen this jacket before. It's kind of like one of the standout pieces from the Season 3 collection. And I think that Season 3 and Season 1 were like some of like the best collections for Yeezy in general. I don't know why people hate on the Yeezy brand so much. I honestly kind of like the clothing line. Like, I think a lot of the clothing pieces honestly look really sick. And some of the shoes too. It's not all the shoes, obviously. The Yeezy Boost stuff, like, it's kind of hit or miss a lot of time. It just kind of depends on like the model, I think. But this jacket is so sick. It's in like this really nice, like, I don't even, like a faded yellow, kind of like almost like greenish. But then on the inside it is a really nice bright yellow for the shirling. It's a pretty basic shirling jacket, so obviously with the collar, you can have it down like this, which is how I normally wear it. But if it's too cold outside, like if I just cannot feel any part of my head because it's so cold, I'll flip up the collar and then you can button this around the front. Obviously you have to have it like zipped up and stuff, but you guys get the idea. It is a really nice high quality jacket. It is extremely heavy. So if you guys are interested in like the Yeezy clothing line, but you don't want to like seem like a hypebeast, I honestly don't think that people will think you're a hypebeast unless you get like the Calabasas track pant type stuff. If you get the branded stuff, I feel like you're probably in it for the branding maybe, but if you get this kind of stuff, I can definitely get behind it. And this stuff is really high quality too. The materials feel great, has an excellent fit too. This is a size large, but it fits like a XL, double XL. It's kind of like how a lot of the Yeezy stuff fits, so you probably want to size down most of the time. I did end up going true to size though, just because there's only one listing on Grailed and I've wanted this for a really long time, so just pulled the trigger and I think it fits cool. It's just like obviously really, really big. This was pretty expensive too. I believe it got for like $650 or $700. I don't remember exactly, but it is a really nice winter jacket. I've been wearing it a lot. I don't know, it's kind of weird, but I feel like this yellow actually does pair up with a lot of stuff. Like it does go well with blue, it goes well with brown, which is what a lot of my pants are. It goes with white shoes, goes with black shoes. It just kind of like works with everything. It's like an interesting shade of yellow. So don't be too afraid to experiment with color a lot of the time. Even though this might seem like a really out there jacket, it kind of pairs up with a lot of stuff, so I don't know. Okay, moving on to another pair of jeans. I have shown you guys these before, but I didn't talk too much about them. I didn't give them enough showtime just because I was trying to rush through the video since it was really, really long, but these are a pair of Mask Studio custom jeans, a custom one-of-one jean. If you guys haven't heard of Mask Studio, they do custom jeans, so they'll go out and buy a bunch of like vintage Levi's or just vintage jeans and flannels and t-shirts in general, and then kind of like repurpose it, stitch it together, customize it in some sort of way, and just give old clothes new life, which I can definitely get behind. It's like very good for the environment, obviously. And these jeans right here, they were completely their design. So obviously they look a little similar to the Undercover 85 jeans, but they do have some differences. Obviously they have different rips and different like distressing and needling all over, but they do have, these jeans do have a bottom cuff right there. So it's kind of hard to tell, but the jeans, the normal pair of jeans, ends right here, but they also sewed another pair of jeans underneath with a longer length. And they told me that if I wanted to, I could cut the part right here, flop over top the shoe, and then have a back flap too, which is like a really interesting design. I haven't decided if I wanted to cut it just yet, just because it's such a cool, nice fitting pair of jeans, and I'm worried that if I cut it, then it won't like stack properly. So I haven't really figured out what I wanna do yet, but I do wear these a ton. Now that I'm in Boston, it's really, really cold, so like, wearing distressed jeans is kind of hard. They have removed all the Levi's branding on the back. I know they spend a ton of time doing like their very meticulous distressing and just like sewing everything back together. They do have to like take the jeans apart. They have to remove the front side and they have to remove the back side and do all the distressing separately and then put it back together. The plus side to these jeans is that they're very, very affordable compared to like Undercover jeans and stuff like that. They have jeans on their website that kind of span from $200 up. The price kind of boils down to how much time and effort they put into each pair. And I'm very, very thankful they sent me another pair of jeans. This is now the third pair of jeans they've sent me. I also have a t-shirt and I have two flannels by them. So my Mask Studio collection is slowly building up, but these are definitely my favorite piece they've made so far. It's just like, it's so easy to wear. I'll have their Instagram right here and their website will be linked down below. All right, you guys, that's gonna do it for part one of this pickups or haul type thing. The second part will be uploaded in 2 days, so definitely keep your eyes out for that. For the time being, I wanna hear your guys' opinion down in the comments. Which of these pickups was your favorite so far? If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. Helps me out so much. Hit the notification bell if you haven't already, just because obviously you wanna know when I post a new video, especially the second part of this pickups haul. It's only gonna get better from here, I promise. These next pickups are pretty insane. I'm definitely looking forward to making more videos for you guys since I have more free time now. I will see you guys in the second part of the pickups haul. Peace out, you guys. Have a good day. See you next time.